I'm Chris Drakely, Professor of Infection and Immunity at the London School of Hygiene and Tropical Medicine. In terms of where we are with kind of the global attack on malaria is three main areas, and the first of those is to scale up our existing interventions such as mosquito nets, the availability of adequate treatment, and then is really to extend that to develop new tools to which we can attack the parasite and the mosquito. But the third pillar is to try and make better use of the information which we collect in malaria endemic countries. And this is surveillance data. And typically in the past, this has simply been used to record the amount and number of cases that have been there. But what we really want to do as a community is turn that on its head and say, now we have identified where those cases are, let's do something about it. One of the things that we are doing is investigating a specific type of malaria, a zoonotic malaria, which is carried by macaques in Southeast Asia, but there have been increasing number of cases in humans. And that malaria has quite a high case fatality rate. So obviously local governments are very interested in understanding a little bit more about that. Part of the reason we think that there's been an increase is changes in the environment and changes in human behavior. It's quite difficult to assess those changes, particularly in the environment, from conventional means such as satellite imagery or even from the ground. One of the things we have done is employed a relatively small drone to allow us to accurately map environmental change in the areas where this malaria is occurring, and to see how changes in forest cover affect macaque movement and human behaviour. And then to try and put those together and to see how that affects the increased risk of getting that malaria. We're one of the few malaria research groups in the world to be able to use drone technology to more accurately map where malaria transmission might be occurring. What the use of these drones has allowed us to do is allow much more frequent assessment of changes in natural environments. So before we would have to rely on the passing of satellites, which is not necessarily very frequent, the drones mean we can fly on any day and get an assessment, a rapid assessment of that ground cover. The drones also have issues around, obviously, can you use them in certain areas? People are can be slightly wary of small drones flying over and people with vested interests in forests or mining or so on and so forth. So that's a certain issue, and there's also general issues about flight paths. So one of the ways that we're using mobile technology is to use tablets with maps in health facilities in endemic countries. So what the mobile phone technology allows us to do is to provide that more accurate description of where malaria is within a community. So rather than the control program having to deliver nets across a whole swathe of an area, they could potentially focus on the areas where malaria is most prevalent or remains. With any new technology, one of the prime issues is working out how much of that information is going to be useful. So I think the primary challenge is, okay, how do we make this the simplest way and simple and effective way to use that? With the mobile phone technology, it's generally staying up to speed with the technological advances such that you don't create something that's obsolete within such a few years that once you've introduced it, it's already kind of been superseded by something more advanced. If we find an area with our mobile phones that has a higher level of malaria, the potential would be that a drone might be able to deliver the supplies there. If we find a particular clinic that says, actually, we're having an experience of more cases, the drone might be able to bring more rapid tests, and it might be able to bring more drugs or even, you know, blood supplies if transfusions are required. So the potential for integrating that would be slightly outside of the remit of the conventional kind of research arena. It's bringing it much more into public-private kind of health practice.